Hello and welcome to yet another brand new edition of Colors of India, our weekly show where we get you a roundup of some important cultural events in the week gone by. I'm Tina Jha. Let's begin the program with glimpses of events we've covered for you during the past week. First up on the show today, a dance production bringing to life the stories of Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. Next, an art exhibition that encapsulates the many worlds of society, politics and life. And then, our weekly focus on regional cinema. We begin the show today with a critically acclaimed dance production, Tales from the Bull and the Tiger. The 82-minute production brought to life the stories of Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati, presented by an ensemble cast of 20 dancers of Shankaranand Kalakshetra. Bringing together Bharatanatyam and Kuchipudi dancers, the narrative enthralled the audience of Delhi. Take a look for yourself.
Padma Vibhushan, Dr. Sonal Mansingh and her Delhi-based Center for Indian Classical Dances, known as the Kamakhya Kalapeeth, presented celebrated dancer and choreographer Anand Shankar Jayant's critically acclaimed dance production, Tales from the Bull and the Tiger, in Delhi recently. Having garnered several accolades down south, the dance production was performed by a vibrant ensemble cast of 20 dancers, bringing to life the stories of Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati, as told by their Vahans Nandi and Singh, or Bull and the Tiger. The performance started with the entry of the bull, tiger, peacock and mushika, all of which are part of Lord Shiva's family. And as it progressed, all elements of nature, namely the earth, water, air, fire and space, formed part of the dance. The story moved forward in a phased manner, introducing the characters, establishing a relationship with other characters, and getting the entire lot involved in the story. Mithun Shyam from Bengaluru and Anand Shankar were seen in the lead roles as Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati respectively. This was followed by some tender scenes depicting Goddess Parvati and her children dancing in joy as they learned about the glory of their parents. The ballet moved at various levels, adhering to the traditional Bharatanatyam format without missing on the drama elements. Both lead characters established their excellence in dance. Their dance, accompanied by the bull and tiger to share mnemonics, was impressive.
नंदी और सिंह की कहानी, ये वाहन है शिव जी और पार्वती जी के, आप सब जानते हैं। तो ये कहानी है शिव और पार्वती जी की, पर कहते हैं नंदी और सिंह उनके कहानियाँ बच्चों को, गणेशा और स्कंदा को। ये मुझे ऐसा लगा कि शिव जी हर वक्त उनके फैमिली के साथ दिखाई देते, तो उस मोड से आ रहा है ये प्रोडक्शन। ये 2018 का प्रोडक्शन है, प्रीमियर पहले बार दिल्ली में हो रहा है।
जो आज आपने देखा है बहुत रेयर टाइप ऑफ प्रोग्राम है, और जिसमें शिव जी का बहुत स्टोरीज ऐसे सीरियल में ये सब आते हैं, पर जब स्टेज का जो आते हैं ऐसे एक जो अग्निलिंग है, इनका सब दिखाना बहुत मुश्किल है। सो आनंदा जी ने इसको ऐसे कोरियोग्राफ किया है ताकि टेक्नोलॉजी को भी यूज़ करके, जो हमारा पौराणिक है, आधुनिक टेक्नोलॉजी यूज़ करके बहुत अच्छे तरीके से ऐसे दिखाया है। तो जो अगले वाले पीढ़ी है इन सब ये सब देखने से उनको पता चलेगा कि आधुनिक और पौराणिक दोनों को मिलके इतना खूबसूरत एक प्रोग्राम कैसे बना सकते हैं, ये सब देख सकते हैं।
Every scene in the ballet was sculpted with the utmost sensitivity and artistry, making it memorable. To add to it, the Kalakshetra style of dance, where aesthetics dominate, be it in costumes, color scheme, stage lights and design, made it a wholesome fair.
मुझे पूरा विश्वास है कि ये बहुत जगह जाएगा, क्योंकि यही ऐसी चीज़ें जो हैं, बिल्कुल ऐसा लगता है परफेक्शन और भक्ति और रस प्रवाह, ये सारा कुछ मिला के एक अद्भुत अनुभव सभी को हुआ। और आपने देखा कि ऑडियंस ने भी एक आवाज़ से उसको सराहना इसकी की है, तो मुझे बहुत ही खुशी है कि इसको हम दिल्ली में लाए हैं।
प्रसार भारती चेयरमैन ए सूर्य प्रकाश एंड इंडियन काउंसिल फॉर कल्चरल रिलेशंस डायरेक्टर जनरल अखिलेश मिश्रा ग्रेस द ओकेजन एज गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर।
टुडेज परफॉर्मेंस वाज एब्सोल्युटली ब्रिलियंट, स्टुपेंडस। ये जब ये शुरू हुआ, शुरू से अंत तक एक क्षण भी हम इधर उधर देखने का या और कुछ सोचने का सवाल ही नहीं उठता। मैं कई सालों से ऐसे कई प्रोग्राम्स मैं देखा हूँ, बट ये आनंदा जी का ये ट्रूप जो है, दिस इज ट्रूली आउटस्टैंडिंग।
महसूस करने के लिए जो हमारे जो पांच जो सेंसेस हैं वो काफ़ी नहीं हैं, उसको अनुभव करने के लिए एक अलग कसौटी पे जाना पड़ता है, और उस कसौटी पे ये जो नृत्य था उस कसौटी पे हमें ले गया।
The 82-minute dance production was taut and aesthetic, adhering to the highest production standards and treating viewers to fascinating tales through brilliant narratives.
ಜ್ವಲಲ್ಲಾಟ ಪಟ್ಟ ಬಾಬ కే కిశోర చంద్రశేఖర్ ఇట్టరి ప్రతిక్షణం మమ.
The presentation of this riveting mythological story is a result of years of painstaking research and months of rigorous rehearsals. We hope you like this impressive dance production. Time for a short break on the program. There's still more lined up for you on the other side. Do stay with us. On the other side of the break, an art exhibition by Prabir Gupta. Welcome back after the break. Throughout history, people across the globe have been fighting against the annihilation of humanity. Archiving these years of activism and showcasing the spirit of citizen protest was the exhibition Family is Plural by Delhi-based artist Prabir Gupta. Through paintings, sculptures and installation works, the artist tried to give socio-political events an artistic, thought-provoking spin. So here's a look at some of his artworks.
Delhi-based artist Prabir Gupta displayed some of his latest art installations, sculptures and paintings at a solo art show in the national capital recently. Organized by Anant Art, the art show titled Family is Plural presented works of art that depict the artist's representation of memory as the point of intersection of personal, political and historical. The show gave socio-political events in an artistic, thought-provoking spin through paintings, sculptures and installation work.
The body of works that you see in this exhibition is, this is quite a large exhibition. It has about, on the whole, about 17 works. Majorly very large works, canvases. I work with multimedia. None of my works are done with only one medium. So even for canvases, I use photographs, I use signboards, I use objects, I use structures.
Prabir's works are based on his engagements with people from different communities. He says, when we live in a society, we need to be sensitive to others' sufferings. And that is why the title of his show, Family is Plural, highlights. For Prabir, a family is not just about blood relationships. It is also about being aware and sensitive towards people and society.
Family is not about blood relations. If I am sensitive enough to understand the situations of people, whether they are suffering or whether they are enjoying, whether they are happy, it is that I also have that same feeling, I share the same feeling. And this is what it is about us, that we don't live in solitude in the mountains, we live in a society and we have to be, you know, sensitive towards each another.
The exhibition displayed more than 17 artworks depicting various themes. One among them was his intricately detailed work titled The Indian Tempest that used both photography and painting. The 9x12 feet work built upon citizen mass movements that marked the Arab Spring earlier this decade and later came to unify India in collective anguish after the 2012 Nirbhaya gang rape case. Through his works, Prabir sought to interact with the public and question the existing existential patterns. Curated by London-based art critic and writer Shaheen Mirali, the exhibition Family is Plural offered images that remind us of our shared humanity despite our diverse subject positions. This is Vandana Kumari's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Through his multimedia works of art, the artist has explored various issues and tried to send out a larger message that the single thread that binds us all is humanity. With that, time for another quick break on the program. There's still more coming up ahead. Don't go anywhere. When we return, we'll talk about Northeast cinema. Welcome back once again. Time now for our weekly segment on cinema, where we celebrate its diversity. In our film segment this week, we once again shift our focus towards Northeast cinema that has plenty to offer. So we are being joined by Mr. Rao Narendra Yadav today, the founder of Woodpecker International Film Festival. The festival, which marked its 7th edition this year, showcased a range of films on a gamut of social issues. So let's go across to him and know what he's going to share with us on the show today. Welcome to Colors of India, sir, and over to you.
Thank you, Tina, for having me on the show. Woodpecker International Film Festival is one of the biggest festivals promoting issue-based independent cinema globally. We started this festival in 2013, and the 7th annual edition of the festival just got over last week. This year, we screened 67 films on 15 contemporary issues from 17 countries. The issues covered range from environment and wildlife to gender, terrorism, children, human rights, public health to culture and religion. Every year, an extremely important segment in our festival is films from the Northeast. In every festival through this segment, we try to showcase powerful and lesser-known stories from the northeastern part of the country. Three interesting documentaries that were screened this year in this segment included In Spite of the Fence, directed by Subimal Bhattacharji, Daughters of the Polo God, directed by Rupa Barwa, and Echo from the Pukpuki Skies, directed by Joshi Joseph. Subimal Bhattacharji's In Spite of the Fence brings you face-to-face with the people of Mahadevpura 3, a small village in Kachar district of Assam, whose lives have become extremely challenging when their village got divided into two parts due to fencing of international border between England and Bangladesh in 2011. Since then, they have been living separately in the sterile zone divided by the fence.
While the people in Mahadevpura 3 seem to be content, yet they know the tough reality that they are divided in spite of being Indian citizens. And life overlaps life in spite of the fence.
Technically, the entire village belongs to India, but those living on the other side of the fence need to get gate pass from BSF to come to this side. And no movement is allowed from dusk to dawn. So their belongingness is questioned every day. Absence of any basic infrastructure and an annual flooding of Surma River further adds to the miseries of these people.
People living on both sides of the fence celebrate together these festivals as one, forgetting the divide that the fence has created among them. Have community prasad and food and go together for the immersion of the deity.
In the 25-minute-long documentary, Subimal has tried to not only share the uncertainty they face and hardships they undergo on a daily basis due to this peculiar situation, but also showcase their emotions, togetherness, and celebrations as the life goes on. It strongly raises a pertinent question for the rehabilitation of the people of Mahadevpura 3.
আর কারেন্ট তো নাই থ্রিতে কারেন্ট নাই ফোর ফোর এর সামনে পর্যন্ত কারেন্ট আজ দিন পর্যন্ত হয়েছেই না
মধ্যে সুর নদী আর সেই নদীকে মনে হইল পরে অকুল জল ধীরে বন্ধু আমি তোমার নাম লইয়া খান্দি
So the second film which we screened in Woodpecker International Film Festival this year was the documentary Daughters of the Polo God, directed by Rupa Barwa. The film beautifully showcased the relationship between people of Manipur and horses and the sacred nature of Manipuri ponies. Very few people know that Manipur has been the birthplace of the modern polo, and it was discovered by the Britishers here. The film focuses on a young polo sisterhood which is developing in Manipur. These young girls play an international polo tournament every year. So the film is a tribute to these female polo players and the modern Manipuri women. The third film that we screened as part of 7th Woodpecker International Film Festival this year was Josie Joseph's Echo from the Pukpui Skies, which is a visual poetry poignantly sharing the trauma of war in Mizoram before the peace accord was signed. Through soulful music, the film showcases the changing lives of people of Mizoram.
Well, thank you, Mr. Rao Narendra Yadav, for joining us on this edition of Colors of India and talking about the interesting lineup of films and documentaries from the Northeast that were screened at the Woodpecker International Film Festival. So, for those of you interested in content-driven cinema that also focus on social issues, these are some of the films mentioned by Mr. Yadav that you could explore in your free time. So that's it from us in the film segment this week. But in our next edition, we'll talk about some other regional films released recently. For the moment, let's take a look at the culture calendar of this week. Chennai will host a Bharatnatyam recital by Anita Ratnam at Sri Krishna Ganasabha, Maharajapuram, Santhanam Road, 7 p.m. on 23rd of December. National capital Delhi will host a trilogue, Triveni, at the Kamani Auditorium, Copernicus Mark, 6:30 p.m. onwards on 27 December. A music concert, Uttar Dakshin, will be held at the Chaudhya Memorial Hall, 16th Crossroad, Malleshwaram in Bengaluru at 6 p.m. on 25 December. And an event, Ehsaas-e Rafi, will be held at Prabodhankar Thakre Natya Mandir, Sudavala Lane, Borivali West in Mumbai, 8:45 p.m. on 24 December. And with that, I'll have to wrap up this edition of Colors of India, but we'll be back same time next week with more updates on the cultural front. In case you missed the television broadcast, you can also watch our program online on YouTube and Twitter, and you can also leave behind your feedback and suggestions about our program. Take good care of yourself and see you again next week.
జటాకటాః సంభ్రమ భ్రమన్ నిలింప నిర్జరీ విలోల వీచి వల్లరీ విరాజమానమూర్ధని ధగద్ధగద్ధగజ్వలల్లాడబట్ట బాబకే కిశోరచంద్రశేఖరిక్తరి ప్రతిక్షణం మమా.